It is November. A full moon rises. Almost 400,000 kilometers away, planet Earth falls under its spell. Our oceans stir. An ancient undersea ritual is underway. Of kilometers. And slow growing. They take between 10 to 30 years to sexually mature and mate at sea. These marine reptiles are nomadic. The creature we call coral is a primitive sac-like Oceans have always absorbed atmospheric CO2 like a giant sponge. But now those levels are so high that the water chemistry is changing, a process referred to as ocean acidification. Alkalinity is falling and naturally occurring carbonate ions are being affected. Many marine creatures need these ions to produce calcium carbonate for their shells and skeletons. Hard corals need them to build reefs. Ocean acidification seriously threatens all these processes. Jellyfish are distant relatives of coral, but unlike coral, they are more adaptable to changes in water temperature. carrying crabs. Sponges are living creatures, but the crab But for first-class travel, nothing compares to a jet-propelled jellyfish. Worms are among the most numerous and diverse of all filter feeders. 20,000 marine species exist. up to 5 years. Another charismatic member of the family is the cuttlefish. These creatures have magical attributes. On the outside, the flamboyant cuttlefish is one of the tiniest cephalopods, yet lives up to its name. Its cuttle bone is too small to float, so it walks more than swims, and it has a highly poisonous flesh, advertised by its pulsing skin. It's also a deadly predator. Two specialized tentacles are contained within a muscular sleeve, which is launched like a spear. With this kind of hunting prowess, it's no wonder the cephalopods have been such a success story on the reef and will no doubt rule the seabed for eons to come. herbivores and dine on algae and even live coral. Other species converge on the reef crest. This area is exposed to wave action and lots of sunlight and is rich in nutrients. Fish like this rock mover wrasse literally move rocks in the search of worms and mollusks. Dining this way is hard work, and they're not always willing to share their patch. Others excavate the substrate and swallow large mouthfuls of sand. Their bodies are specially designed to filter the sand for algae, dispelling waste through their gills. Access to the reef crest is limited. It's only at certain tides and during calm seas that it's possible to feed here. When all the conditions are right, fish arrive from miles around. The night shift has begun. Little is known about our oceans. The surface of Mars is better mapped. Most living coral reefs descend to only 50 metres or so due to the reliance on sunlight. But the sea floor falls to 11 kilometres in places. This is what we call the abyss. Nighttime on the reef gives us a sense of what this abyss might be like. The inky black is very much alive. And full of aliens. In special places where reefs drop to great depth, deep sea plankton rise to the surface to hunt shallow water phytoplankton. They travel hundreds of meters, they number in their billions, and they repeat the journey every night. It's one of the biggest migrations in the animal kingdom. The chase of plankton hunter and plankton prey triggers a larger chain reaction right across the nighttime reef. The water flashes with colour as the plankton frantically communicate with one another. Coral is not an idle bystander. The reef has become a wall of mouths. The true animal nature of coral is revealed. Equipped with poisonous harpoons and acid, each polyp becomes a deadly trap from which escape is impossible. Down on the seabed, scavengers collect the scraps. While lionfish use their long spines to herd unsuspecting prey. Underwater lights give us a glimpse. We still know very little about what happens on a reef at night. And our unwarranted fears have made it harder to learn. Our attitude to the sea has been full of contradiction. On the one hand, we've revered it. On the other, we've seen it as an enemy, dark and unfathomable, full of dragons and monsters. These monsters of the deep have long been proven figments of our collective imagination. But some believe they still exist in the form of sharks. How wrong they are. These magnificent creatures predate dinosaurs. Like coral, they've survived several mass extinctions. A big school of fish is a defining image of a healthy sea. It's a show of strength, an incredible physiological adaptation. Running head to tail in most fish is a row of scales known as the lateral line. Connected to nerves in the brain, this line consists of specialised cells that are sensitive to water displacement and movement. Meanwhile, fish's eyes are located on the sides of their heads to make it easy to see where they are in relation to one another. So vision helps maintain angle and distance between fish, while the lateral line dictates speed and direction of the entire school. In this way, many fish can move as one and choreograph their own aquatic ballet. In the quest to survive in these tropical seas, animals have had to be highly connected by areas of sand and rubble. There are over 2,000 species of goby, making them one of the largest fish families. Few of them grow bigger than your finger, Territorial disputes are normally quick to work out, but not always. Is the presence of us. For the first time in coral's existence,